Stay tuned for the biggest fish, the hottest bites, this week here on In-Depth Outdoors. With James Holst.
Look at that. Wow, is that an incredible fish?
And the rest of the IDO fishing team. We're headed to the best fisheries across the upper Midwest and Canada. We'll fish longer, explore unfished bodies of water, and go further off the beaten path in search of the hottest bites in fresh water. With Pat McSherry.
All right, what a fish.
Andy Fioco.
Wow.
Look at the colors on this fish.
And Mike Anselmo.
Man, he's bumping.
This is In-Depth Outdoors.
Good morning, everyone. James Holst here with In-Depth Outdoors. Thanks for tuning in to this week's episode. Now, we're getting close to the end of our broadcast season here at In-Depth Outdoors. After today's show, we've only got two more weeks in the field. So what we wanted to do with today's show is really mix things up. We've been on kind of a run of open water walleye shows, and you know what? Variety is a spice of life. So what we wanted to do was find a different bite for a different species that even I have never targeted at this time of the year. So what we're gonna do is we're headed to Lake Superior, and I'm gonna be fishing with Jordan Millette, and our target is gonna be early season coho. And what's interesting about this bite is, you know, Lake Superior coho don't get very big. If you wanna catch a big salmon, you go to Lake Michigan. But these coho on Lake Superior are plentiful, they're fantastic on the table, and they offer a phenomenal break from that nonstop walleye action that we've been into for the last 4 weeks. So do stick around. I'm gonna be fishing with Jordan Millette from Escanaba, Michigan on the southern shore of Lake Superior for spring run coho.
Miles an hour?
Yep.
All the baits we're running probably dive 4 to 6 feet at the max. We're running 12 pound suffix mono out behind these boards, and of course we're on Lake Superior. The water clarity is so good that these bright colors produce pretty well for these coho. They're up here in schools just running around looking for bait fish, and when one of these really bright colored stick baits go by, they stick out like a sore thumb in that water, of course. The planer boards, of course, serve two purposes. One, to get the lures away from the boat. Fish aren't gonna be really eager to eat a lure that's fished right near the boat in super clear water like this. And of course, when you're fishing out a body of water like Lake Superior where you can fish multiple lines, these planer boards really help spreading out your lures. You know, with Jordan and I in the boat, we can legally fish 6 rods. Pretty tough to do without the planer boards.
There's one.
Hey, look at this guy. Well, we know the pixie spoons work. I'm not gonna net them for you. Well, if you can't catch them trolling, just start casting, right?
That's it.
You said we could do it.
A little brown, it looks like.
Nice. Two boards out one side, three boards out the other, and a guy up front casting.
You don't wanna keep him, do
No,
you?
I don't, no, I'm good. We're holding out for the cohos.
Middle board, James.
You come get it, bud.
Alrighty.
I got one on the outside board over here, too. 100%. I'll get this one off. Wouldn't you know it. I got some stuff to take you. Absolutely, my outside board's got a fish on it. I just wished that chartreuse and white jointed on that outside there.
Nice.
Holler when you need me.
I think he's flossing up there.
Something little there.
I don't think this one's real big either. Oh, yeah, no, it's really small.
What you got there?
I think it's a little steelhead.
Is it?
A little rainbow maybe, or maybe it's a coho. Hard to tell. They're so young.
So itty bitty. Well, a little pocket of them over there in the corner. Not what we're looking for as far as size. Thank you.
That's still a coho. Looks like anyway, maybe.
little guy. We're gonna give him a chance to grow up, become a bigger coho. About 13 inches long. Kind of looking for him about that 20 inch range. All right, well, that was a lot of kerfuffle for two small fish. outside board. Turn us out just a little bit here.
Okay, is that one?
It feels like a good fish. We'll need a net on this one. Chartreuse, jointed number 9. This is the second fish we've had. I've had it out maybe 10 minutes.
So I'm gonna pull this one right out, James, or leave it in the holder here?
Oh, that should be fine.
Okay.
You know, this bite, this is the first time I've ever done this. For years, I've heard about this bite, you know, from all the way from Duluth, all along the southern shore of Lake Superior. Sometime in April, after the ice comes off. I mean, Lake Superior doesn't get ice every year, but you know, once you start getting those warm days, the water temperatures just start to rise just a little bit. You get these cohos, steelhead brown mix up shallow. And as you can see, we're just basically pulling right off a beach. We've had our better bite here on the sand. We started out on the rock, but right now everything's on the beach, which is just fine by me. You don't snag up any lures. You don't have to worry about putting the boat up on any rocks. Thank you. Love it. All right, let's see what we got here. Oh, there he's jumping, trying. Coho, it looks like.
Yeah.
Water's so clear, I can't see the fish, but I can see the bait clear as day. What we got? Oh yeah, coho. Whoop, thank you. Oh, just come off, perfect. Let me grab that bait out of there. I think we'll let him go, he's not very big. Whoop. You say he's about 15 inches?
Yeah.
Yeah, actually that's just fine. I'll keep him.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I'm gonna keep one more and then we're gonna call it good on the keeping of fish. And here's what that fish came on. Chartreuse, silver belly, number 9 jointed. A lot of action out of a small bait. They don't dive very deep. Got that tiny little bill. You know, the warmest water out here on Lake Superior right now is gonna be shallow and near the surface. So these coho, they're just not very deep. There's no, you know, don't, I've got downriggers on here. You don't need them today. You don't need lead core. You don't need any extra weight. These fish are shallow and you can get by basically with what amounts to walleye gear. You know, these aren't the biggest salmon. So throwing all that extra gear at them sometimes takes a lot of the fun out of them. Being able to catch these fish with as light a gear as possible really makes it that much more fun.
Authentic Series Soft Baits from B-Fish and Tackle are just what the doctor ordered if you want to scratch your big fish itch. Available in two body styles, the Moxie Auger Tail and the Pulsar Paddle Tail offer a perfected blend of field-tested color patterns and hyperactive designs that come to life in the water. To produce unparalleled fish-catching movement and vibration, other soft baits just can't match. Authentic Plastics, your prescription-strength cure for slow fishing. Only from B-Fish and Tackle. Everything you'd expect from a premium quality fish house and so much more. Glacier combines superior craftsmanship and premium quality materials to produce a comfortable and enjoyable mobile base camp for your next outdoor adventure. Available in a variety of models, a Glacier Ice house offers more standard features, more usable space, and a better fit and finish than the competition. Visit our website at glacierisehouse.com to find a dealer near you and see why a Glacier fish house is the ultimate way to play.
Paid to put fish in the boat, you don't mess around with the thing that puts fish in the boat. Always use the best line.
The states along the southern shore here of Lake Superior allow a guy to fish 3 rods apiece. So what we're doing is we've got 3 board rods out one side, 2 out the other, and that frees up Jordan to actually cast a spoon out the front. A lot of days he's able to put quite a few fish in the boat doing that. And of course, if you can catch fish casting, it's always a lot of fun. So that's kind of how we have the lines all broke out here. We've got three boards on the inside. All but one fish has come on the inside, and we just basically swap rods around every time we turn around to make sure that we've got one more rod on that inside, because that just seems to be where the fish are at right now. They're very shallow. Inside board, inside board. Ain't very big. It's a top one, yeah. What lure was that? Do you remember?
I think it's a thunderstick.
Yep, that's that clown.
Clown, is it?
Yep. Yeah. What do we have? A little brown trout, a little rainbow, a couple little rainbows. A
couple little rainbows, a couple cohos.
It's a buffet. All right, I'm out of your way. Just a little guy, huh?
Yeah. Not another little guy. This little coho.
Little coho? Well, that's the kind of fish that'll get a hook in your finger like right now, won't they?
Another one on the clown.
Those are the only two baits that are produced, really. Yeah. On the clown, thunderstick, 3.5 inch, and then the jointed chartreuse and silver. Whoop. So kind of starting to see a pattern come together here. We've got three fish in the box right now, and we've fished the rock walls that lead back into this bay. Everything's been on the sand. There's kind of a nice beach here, and for whatever reason, all these fish, the rainbows, the browns, and the cohos, everything's up here on the shallow sand. It could be a little warmer. I'm just looking at my temperature gauge. A degree, probably not a big deal. But for whatever reason, this is where they're at. So we'll keep working it.
In-depth outdoors, spot on the spot ID.
In today's spot on the spot ID, we're gonna take a look at Lake Superior and share some ideas on how to find these coho in the spring. Now, remember, this is my first time on the water actually chasing this species at this time of the year, so forgive me for not having years of experience to share here, but I do have some basic principles that you can put to use if you wanna get out on the water and target this species of fish early in the season. So if you're in Minnesota, chances are, if you have any interest in fishing Lake Superior, you've heard about the coho fishing early in the season, and that happens up the south shore in this area. Anglers will start right near Duluth and work up the shoreline towards the Apostle Islands, and that bite will last for several weeks. Shawamigan Bay has a very good bite for a mixed bag, coho, browns, and steelhead. And as you work further to the west, just about every large boat harbor, and when I say large, I'm not talking about 6, 8, 10, 20 boats. I'm talking about those large commercial harbors that have the huge break walls. Those attract a really good run of coho as well. And what's nice about that is, if you don't want to get the boat out of storage, you can actually fish the coho in those locations from shore. Now, we were fishing in Michigan waters, and we found that any protected bay where you could find slightly warmer water temperatures and some good water color held these coho. So what we looked for was warmer water, but also a place where there was a tributary dumping in that off-color water. And that's all it took to really concentrate these fish. So it's a huge lake. You take a look at it on the map, and let me tell you, it's daunting. But once you have just kind of a rudimentary understanding of what it takes to locate these fish, it gets so much easier to find them. So if you find yourself in need of a break from that early season spring walleye fishing, give these early season coho out on Lake Superior a try. They're a ton of fun. The scenery is incredible, and they're tough to beat on the table.
In pursuit of what lies beneath, Okuma Fishing Tackle is the point of connection between angler and opportunity, giant pike and muskie, drag screaming salmon, and deep-bodied lake trout, hard-fighting bass, and the elusive walleye, all pursued by anglers that demand the smoothest, longest casting reels and perfectly balanced fishing rods, engineered to perfection everywhere, every species. Okuma Fishing Tackle is inspired fishing.
Thank you.
Skeeter Boat Center is now a full-service Warrior Boats dealer, offering the complete line of Warrior Boats, all covered by reliable Yamaha outboards. With dealerships located in Ramsey, Minnesota and Chippewa Falls, Wisconsin, Skeeter Boat Center carries more Warrior Boat models in stock than any other Warrior Boat dealer. No matter which Warrior model is right for you, you'll receive the same attention to detail and service after the sale that made Skeeter Boat Center the number one Skeeter dealer by volume in the Midwest. For the best selection of fiberglass fishing boats and unmatched service, stop in or visit us online at SkeeterBoatCenter.com.
There's one.
Look at that. Jordan's got one on the spoon. I don't got. There, got that? Sweet. I'm gonna go get that board.
Alrighty.
We got one there. We've got one there. It's a free for all.
Chaos.
That sandbar is the deal. There's a little sandbar point that comes off this beach. Sticks out about 75 yards. And you can't pull a bait over the top of it without catching a coho salmon right now. You couldn't pick a prettier place to fish. And these fish are so aggressive. Shall we say cooperative? I'm just gonna lift.
Yeah, I'll probably do the same. Cookie cutter.
Yep. All right, buddy. That's a good one for the box. Yours is a good one for the box. That was a good one. Need the pliers?
Oh, we're good. Cool. Fire tiger, that one. I think that's our first time fire tiger today.
You still got one up front.
Yeah.
On the spoon.
Yeah, let's get that one. I just got that one casting on a pixie spoon. Pink and silver. One of our bigger ones today.
That's why we've been keeping one of those rods out of the water today.
That's right.
So a guy could do that. Inside board.
Yep, there you go. Man, that's like clockwork.
I love it.
There we go.
Yep, inside board.
What is the better fish, James?
You know, I think we've caught enough trolling here where I think we should spot lock on that little sandbar and cast to it.
That'd be a good idea, I think, yeah.
I'm hurrying.
That's a good one.
I don't need any more. Boy, that fish was going nowhere. Little coho, see you next year. Let's see if I can get over here. Manage the chaos, right? Because the wind has picked up a little bit.
It has.
Switched directions. It's blowing into this corner on the sandbar. And as the wind's picked up, the fishing's just getting better and better.
Yeah, every time we pass over that bar, it's like clockwork.
Oh, what the heck?
I guess it ain't that big. Man, it felt a lot bigger than that.
I just threw the bigger one back.
That was weird. That one actually fought.
It happens. Since we got most of the rods in, let's go back and fire cast on that sandbar.
I like it.
Take the rod. I've got plenty. Whoop!
Perfect.
Kind of made the decision for you. This is either going to be a complete waste of time or a ton of fun. Oh, look at you! I'm going to be fishing to switching to a spoon quick. That's like you had a hit on your first cast.
Yeah,
that's like your fourth cast, and that's
there.
Your second. You got another one hooked up already. That's the advantage of the pixie spoon. You can bomb it about a quarter
that's
of a mile.
That's just it. Yeah, you cover a little more water.
This is a no net zone when we're casting, man.
Come on. Another coho.
Good work.
She's using a pink pixie spoon. Just come out and crunched it.
Yeah, I think that one's a half ounce.
Yep, half ounce. Yeah, they hit it with authority, that's for sure.
Well, I tell you what, I know you grabbed one out of the box for me because you were pretty sure I was going to need it. If you throw it back here, that'd be great.
Pink or chartreuse silver?
Throw me a pink.
Okay, yeah, I don't blame you for trying that one.
Oops. Perfect. Thank you.
Look at that. Man, they really crunch it, though. It's like a brook trout, you know?
Sure. Wah. Slash. Kill it on the hit.
Authentic Series Soft Baits from B-Fish and Tackle are just what the doctor ordered if you want to scratch your big fish itch. Available in two body styles, the Moxie Auger Tail and the Pulsar Paddle Tail offer a perfected blend of field-tested color patterns and hyperactive designs that come to life in the water. To produce unparalleled fish-catching movement and vibration, other soft baits just can't match. Authentic Plastics, your prescription-strength cure for slow fishing. Only from B-Fish and Tackle.
In pursuit of what lies beneath, Okuma Fishing Tackle is the point of connection between angler and opportunity, giant pike and muskie, drag screaming salmon, and deep-bodied lake trout, hard-fighting bass, and the elusive walleye, all pursued by anglers that demand the smoothest, longest casting reels and perfectly balanced fishing rods. Engineered to perfection, everywhere, every species, Okuma Fishing Tackle is inspired fishing.
At Aluma, we're in it for the long haul. That's why we make the longest lasting, most rugged trailers on the road. Flatbeds, bike haulers, tilt trailers, and enclosed. If you have a lot to move, we've got your way to move it. Our lightweight aluminum trailers will handle even your heaviest loads. At Aluma, we are right behind you with an industry-leading 5-year warranty. Because every trip and every load is valued.
I'm going to have my pink back. You're killing me. Double.
Nice.
Doubly.
Yours looks better.
Another, I can tell you, mine feels better.
Up she goes.
I don't mind being a spectator once in a while, but that was getting old. You were cleaning my clock. Double coho.
Another one on the pink pixie. It's been the hot spoon. Okay, we'll let this one go.
You got a double here. I was in need of one badly. Jordan was out fishing me pretty handily. It's a nicer one though. I tell you what, when they hit,
it feels like— Is that a chartreuse?
Yeah, that was chartreuse. When they hit it, they feel like they're going about 15 miles an hour, and it's just collision.
Big time.
A lot of force for a fish that's 18 inches long. See you later.
That was awesome.
Yeah, well, we'll do this for a while. We'll go out troll deeper for a while. We'll make a day of it, right?
I can handle that.
I got him.
Nice.
X-wrap on the pause.
Double.
Double. This is too cool. All right, fall off now. Do it. All right, come here.
A little better one.
A little nicer one?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, what was
that?
Was
a brown or a spike, I think.
Was it? Nice. Yep. Yeah. Whoa. Easy. We're going to let you go. Nice coho. A teener. Actually, your spike or brown, whatever that was definitely bigger than that coho.
That was close to 20, I would say.
Number 8 X-wrap. And the thinking there was, you know, so many of these fish are just slashing. You see them just kind of make a huge turn on the baits. And then, you know, the spoon, you have to reel it away. But what we're able to do with the X-wrap is we see those baits, or see those fish come in and take a slash at it. You can just twitch the bait and stop it. And that one just did exactly what they're supposed to do. Twitch the X-wrap, stop it. It just kind of hovers there in the water column. That fish came right back and just slurped it right up.
That's awesome.
Super cool. And you get to see the whole darn thing.
Oh, right in.
Whoa!
A little better one too.
That's a nice coho, isn't it?
See if we can't get this on the boat. I'm gonna go down for this one.
What, no double this time?
I'm gonna call it another spiker, laker, one of the two.
Splaker?
Splaker.
You know what's interesting is we never caught a single one of them trolling.
Yeah, that's odd, isn't it? Nice splake. Silver colors on them. Go ahead and let this one go.
Bloop! Off he goes.
Yeah, that one hit right at the boat. Another one on that pink. That's been the moneymaker.
It's like a spectator sport. You can watch everything that goes on. I mean, those fish, they're so fast, but you can see them so well in the water. Like little black missiles tracking you down.
And it's clear water, don't take much to see them. It's all about finding that speed where they'll hit it, mm-hmm. instead of just chasing it right to the boat, seems like.
Fish.
That's too cool.
Oh, he's fast. Come here.
Need a hand? You want a net?
No,
dude?
I got him. Woo, little bigger one.
Nice.
Giving me the beans over here.
Might be a brown, James.
Well, now he's rolled up in it. There we go. Laker, Splake. I don't know, man. I'm going to say Laker. If I'm wrong, so be it. We're getting it all up here. Definitely a nice fight on that one. Small lake trout, maybe 18, 19 inches long. All right, we're getting the smorgasbord. So what is the distinctive telltale for a splake?
I think the splake's got a little more flat of a tail, not so much of a fork tail.
So that one's definitely a laker.
Yeah, probably.
Back you go. See, now I've caught splake up in Ontario, and they were very distinctive. You knew when it was a splake. It wasn't a lake trout. It was basically
all colored up like a brook trout almost.
All colored up, yep. Okay. Very easy to tell. Why do I try different? Oh,
that was a good one too.
It looked like a really good one. The hit is the best part.
It is. They just
crush it.
Come on, glued on it.
Hey, little guy. I threw that one inside.
Right up on the beach.
Right up on the beach. Small guy though. Come here, you. This casting bite has slowed down a little bit. It was just fast and furious for a while, but the wind has switched. Instead of blowing right in here, we have the wind kind of paralleling the shoreline. And what's happening now is what was real, you know, milky, cloudy water, it's dissipating. And these fish are definitely more aggressive when you have reduced water clarity. I think I got myself a little brownie. Just a little guy. Got some spots and dots there. Just a small guy. It's good to see those though. You know, so many places here on the Great Lakes, they've cut back stocking, and in some areas they've actually stopped stocking the brown trout. Lots of them around here. Is that natural reproduction then up in the rivers?
Yep.
So that brings us to the end of today's show. And let me tell you, as somebody that's never targeted these spring run coho, I had no idea they were this plentiful. And you're gonna have a hard time finding a more beautiful place in the world to go spend the day out there on the water. So a huge thanks to Jordan Millette. He's a fantastic angler, and I really enjoyed my time with him out there in the boat. So to everyone that tuned in today, thanks for watching. We'll see you next week.
For more info on the latest fish reports, gear recommendations, and hottest techniques, connect with us online at indepthoutdoors.com or follow us on Facebook at In Depth Outdoors. And if you enjoyed today's show, be sure to let our sponsors know.